Imagine setting up client reputation management once, then watching 5-star reviews roll in on Autopilot. In this video, I'm going to show you the Go High Level hack that makes your agency look like a results machine without all the extra work. So the high level hack I am talking about is actually a simple strategy, okay, that has 3 parts to automating reputation management. Now, I want to make this abundantly clear. This is not a reputation management tutorial. I have a ton of other videos on that. If you're brand new to this, please watch those. This is just going to be how to currently automate the process you have. This also isn't going to be database reactivation and getting a bunch of leads right in the door and getting a bunch of reviews right as you start. I have other videos on that, and I have more coming out on this exact thing. This is how to take the current system you have of getting reviews or boosting your local SEO and putting it on autopilot so you don't have to work so much. Okay, so there is really 3 parts to this. And the first part is you have to have the right reputation management automation. So this is the first part we will be covering. So this is going through the automation I have for you if you want it, or setting up your own where reviews can come on autopilot and then you can remove people from the system that already got review requests if they have left a review. Very important. A lot of novices out here aren't doing that. They're letting people come in and they're just hammering the same people with review requests when they've already left a review. That's a no-no. You don't want that. Number two, okay, reviews AI. You want a predictable way to answer the reviews, okay, to make sure everything is professional, legit, and it works on autopilot. Very important for the algorithm. Then number three, this one's kind of an interesting one, but it's review tools. And you'll see I'm talking QR codes, website review widgets, and stuff like that to get reviews in other ways. Very important, very underrated, but it actually gets a lot of reviews trickling in. And we're gonna be covering all three of these. And the whole goal is to make sure that after you watch this video, we can automate your reputation management so you don't have to worry about this anymore. So without further ado, let's jump into number one, which is reputation management automation. So you need a high-powered automation for this to work properly. Okay, I know some people have multiple to do this. This one, which is massive, can do it for you. I wanna let you know this is completely free with my high-level affiliate link down below. Okay, I have other ones I give away, but they're not as good. You can build your own. You don't have to have this one. This one is just really powerful, and it is completely free when you get that link down below. So if you want it, just go right down below. So this is really interesting. Basically, the first thing is you want to just make sure your triggers are after you have done said job. It's going to look different for different people, but that way you've actually serviced them. And if you're using another software, Jobber, QuickBooks, any of these other things, you can set up Zapier to basically bring them in, the contacts in, to then send them review requests. Okay, so that's very important. I have other videos covering that. That is a very important part if they're not all in high level. So you can do this really with anyone's system. But the whole point is after you have said job done, you want to have an automation that sends them review requests via SMS and email. Then you want to have a trigger link set up that when they click it and it goes through, okay, if they leave a review, it then removes them from the workflow. So I know right now it's kind of hard to quantify whether they left it or not because it's the email on their GMB, not in your contacts. So there is a little bit of issues with that at times. But for the most part, if they go through, we want to remove them from the workflow after they've gone through and left a review. Very important. This is like critical. That's why automations like this help. And again, you get this whole thing for free down below, or you can make your own. They just take it for freaking ever. But then from there, it times out. It waits a couple days if they haven't clicked it, sends it again, and then it goes through this same process to make sure that they have left said Google review. And again, when they leave a review, it adds a tag, it removes them from the workflow. It's all automated. So if you get this fully set up, you can basically hands off and it will just send review requests like that. And I've used this exact automation for my clients and for my hair salon, which has been crushing. Okay, we're new and we were able to get 170 Google reviews. We didn't do any database reactivation. That's something we should do here very soon, but this has been doing so well. We were able to get 170 Google reviews in less than a year, and it's just been cranking and doing really well on Google. And part of that is because this amazing automation does it all on autopilot. Okay, again, I wanna stress this. You cannot have fully automated reputation management if you don't have the correct automation that is sending review requests after you've done the job and then removing them from the workflow if they left a review. Like, that is it in simple, but it's more complicated to build because there's a lot of factors. So again, if you already have an automation, just make sure it does those things. Go down below, check out the 30-day free trial, you'll get access to live coaching calls, snapshots, so much more. For your AI agents, we all have a lot of stuff on reputation management because they go hand in hand with the AI agency. It's the future, guys. And it is the best way to grow service-based businesses when you mix AI marketing and reputation management. So again, make sure you have that. And guys, if you have any questions at all about anything, about the link down below or on this, please drop a comment down below. I answer so fast. Okay, I answer pretty much every single comment that comes in. And I do this because I want to help you out. And you can look at my other videos, you see, I answer all the comments. I'm very diligent about this, but I want to help you out. So if you have questions on this or you're confused, drop a comment down below. Okay, so now that you have your automation dialed, then we move on to number two, which is reviews AI, which plays hand in hand with number one. So to navigate to reviews AI, you're going to come into your dashboard, click reputation management, and then right up here, you're going to come all the way and click settings. And it's going to be right here, reviews AI. So all you're going to do with this is you're going to turn it on automatic and then do a wait time before responding so it doesn't look sketchy. That's it. And once you do that, what it's going to do is it's going to go on here and every time someone leaves a review, it is going to respond to it. If you didn't know, you can respond to the reviews. Very important. It helps with local SEO. It's very important. Here's a massive pro tip, which I see a lot of people don't do. If you are randomly getting a ton of reviews and you turn this on too quickly, I think it can run into problems on Google because they're like, oh, you're clearly using AI to do all this stuff. The reason it works for me and every business I've done this with is because I'm already having people manually answer their reviews before we had reviews AI. So if you already have a history of doing that, it'll already work really well. Make sure to just keep that in mind because that is an important note. But I would leave 15 minutes. That's a good one. Down here, you can create agents to answer reviews in different tonalities. I don't really think this is that important right now. Like if you come and click create agent, you'll see Claire Flair, Grace Space, Taylor Sailor. It's just like, you know what I mean? It's just like, it helps, but it's like you'll be provided with negative reviews of your business, write a heartfelt and empathetic. Like it's good, but with this regularly and what you have now, it's already going to work really well. If you want to make it a little bit better, you can create agents. But this, again, the whole point of this is to answer said reviews that came in. And again, there's the cost of AI. It's like 0 point something cents. Check it out. It's very, very cheap, but it's very important to have this turn on or you have to do it manually. And if you want to pay someone to do it or you want to take the time out of your day to answer a review, you can, but it's a bit of a time waste and it takes forever because you got to really think of responses. But this works well. It's what I use for me and all of the businesses I've done this with. It's awesome. Make sure you use this. This is the second step, is coming right in here, going to settings, turning this on, putting 15 minutes, and then you are good to go. Again, questions on this, guys, drop them down below. Seriously, I'm here to help. Drop them down below. So now that we've done number one and number two, we move on to number three, which is review tools. Now, this one is actually optional. Like you don't have to do this if you have these two set up. But if you really want to blow your clients out of the water and get way more results, I recommend doing this. It helps a lot. I've seen it absolutely crush with people. I'll bring up an example later, but I really think this is very, very important to do. But again, you can pretty much automate reputation management with the right automation and reviews AI. But with this, I think it's really important that you do it. It helps a lot. It's like that unfair advantage competitive moat example. So to access the website review widgets, we're going to come back into high level, go to reputation, and we're going to come right up in here into widgets. Now, all a widget is if you do not know, it is a place, okay, where you will see your reviews on a website. They'll pop up cool different ways, and then it gives an option to leave a review. Very powerful, as you see here, for social proof, but also getting people to leave a review because we're herd animals. So you have a couple different options. You can create new completely from blank. This is just going to be you completely from a blank canvas creating this. Or what you can do is you can come right back here, okay, and click templates. And in here, you can pick the exact kind of review template you want. So we're going to click the orange one, and we're going to click edit widget. So I'm not going to go through every single button because all it is doing is editing this widget. I have other videos on this. But just to know, all of these things here are what's going to edit the widget. So up here, we have a couple different things, you know, to edit the size, the look. You can try to change right here the way it looks, like the grid versus masonry. Right in here, okay, this is just going to, you know, the heading up there, the description right there, very simple stuff. This is all of your colors right here. You pick, you know, your fonts and whatnot. Then this is the code we can put on the website. So very simple, but a couple important things to note. So once you get all this, you want to pick your review source. So you can pick all or just the Google, which is what we're going to pick. Then what we're going to do is we're going to come down here and we're going to want to make sure we either leave this on or off depending on your brand. If you want to say powered by Zoe Zimmerman Hair Salon or whatever your brand is, leave that on. If it's your clients, you want to make sure it's them. If you want to turn it off, you click that and it's off. Now, you could technically put powered by your agency on other people's website, so it's a backlink to you. You might want to ask permission for that though. That's important, but you can do that. Then once you have that and you see everything is the way you is and you like it, you're like, this is really cool, you're going to click save. Then it's going to prompt you to name it. So what we're going to do is we're going to do Zoe Zimmerman Hair Salon on review widget. Okay, then we're going to click save. Now that you have it, it's right here and it's save. So now what we want to do is we want to click this, make sure we have it, then click this code and make sure we have the proper one selected down here because that'll be the proper code. Then you're going to click copy code. Then what you want to do is you want to go to said website you're using or wherever you want to put this. Again, you can put this on any website, Wix, Squarespace, WordPress, High Level, whatever. You can take some code. It'll just be a code editor. You can find these anywhere. Click into this, go into open code editor, then click paste. Once it's in like this, you just click save. Then we preview it. And you'll see right here, the beautiful review widget popped up. Just like that, they can leave a review you want, and everything is already set up. So that is a way to add the review widgets to sites. You can add to any site. I think it's very important for showing social proof. It really builds a lot of, you know, clout, and it's an easy place for them to leave a review. Hence, review tools. It's an easy way to get a couple of reviews. Very important. Now, okay, that we understand this, we move on to the last part, which is a really underrated strategy, which I have seen people crush with, which is QR codes. Now, what I recommend you do with these is you put these in person if you want to go above and beyond. I'm going to go right to sites. We'll come right to QR codes, and this is where you will find said QR codes. Now, what a QR code is one of these things that you scan with your phone, and it takes you to the review portal. So if we come into create QR code, okay, we'll have a couple of different options. So first, name it. We're going to do ZZ QR code. You pick what you want. We're going to do review link. We're going to click next. Okay, this is where you want to put the review link in. Now you can take what you have in High Level. Again, if you know reputation management, it'll be right in there. If you are completely new to this and you don't have it, you can come to your GMB. You can go right into reviews. You can come right up here, get more reviews, copy said link right here. Okay. Come back and paste it in just like that. And we're going to want to make sure this is Google. Okay, paste that in. And then we're good to go. Then you can pick however you want to edit this, the way it looks with this stuff right here. It's just, you know, whatever you want. Then we're going to click next. Same thing. You can pick the way the QR code is. Right here, you can have this stuff pop up if you want. We're just going to leave it all as is. You can upload your logo. This is all up to you. Again, I have other videos going in depth on this. I'm just showing you the point of this, not how to do every button. But just know that all of these things are how to edit this and make it look better. From there, you can either link it or download it. And what I recommend you do is you download it and then you can have it. Now, what will happen is if someone puts their phone up to it and they scan, I mean, shit, you can even do it right now. When you do this right now, it'll take them to the review page, okay? Then they can leave a review. I've seen people that have rejected my services in the past just light up their office or their shop with QR codes everywhere. Like for restaurants, they put it on the table with the little menu, they put it on the door, and they get a ton of reviews. Google actually used to create QR codes for you and send them to you in the mail. This used to be a thing they used to do that was awesome. Maybe they still do it. I remember they discontinued it a couple years ago, but it was sick. They would like send you these QR codes that were like these really nice stickers that you could slap on, and they would get you reviews. Because after someone does a good job, where you're at a restaurant or someplace where you have a lot of interactions, you can put these and it'll get a lot of extra reviews. So this is just one of those unfair advantages that if you want to take it to the next level, I recommend you do this. Again, this is killer for restaurants, places where people are hanging out and constantly see it and they get a good service. I recommend you do it. Also too, like if you're in a restaurant and a server does a good job, you can basically tell the wait staff, or you obviously pass this down the chain of command, but say, hey, after they do a good job, you know, to scan the QR code right there and you'll be good to go. Because I know some people, like after you pay, they'll send you emails and texts, but this is a really easy way to do it because it immediately pulls up on your phone and it's right there. And if you do a good job, it incentivizes them. So just to let you know, that is something you can do to take it to the next level. It helps a lot. I've seen people crush with it. I've done it myself. It's one of those things that if you want to just go a little bit further, I think you should do it, and it helps a ton. If your client does not want to do reputation management at all, like the way you're proposing with the automations and all this stuff, this is always your backup. So remember, you got a lot of leeway with these tools. So the last thing I want to say is that reputation management is part of something bigger, which is local SEO, which is becoming even more important in the AI search engines or answer engines, whatever you want to call them. And there's other things you need to know. So what I want to do is I want to link videos at the end of this video that go into the full reputation management tutorial and local SEO because it's so powerful. That actually brings me to one of my points is that if you are doing this and you have an AI agency or reputation management agency, I have a community that's super in depth on all of this stuff by signing up with that link down below. Now, here's the cool part about this. When you sign up with this link, you're getting access to over $10,000 of free bonuses when you sign up, okay? So that's trainings on how to master High Level, trainings on how to sell High Level, reputation management, AI, like the whole nine yards, okay? 5 live coaching calls, per week with different coaches that are doing this. Okay, not VAs I hired somewhere else or just me. We have actual agency coaches that are doing this same thing right now that can help you out. I mean, there's no better way to learn from people that are in the trenches doing it now. And you can access that for free. Tons of snapshots. We have snapshots in almost every vertical. Okay, so you can have the complete AI agency. Because in 2025, you have to have an AI agency. If you just have one thing, it's not enough. You have to have that. Then we have sales scripts, AI prompts, and so much more that you get all for free by signing up with that link down below. So I recommend you check that out, guys. All this stuff is free, okay, when you sign up with that link down below. There is also another link if you already have high level, you want to check it out. It'll show you how to get in an alternate way. But if you're wanting to have an AI agency, really boost the reputation management side of things in your company, I recommend you check that link out. It will help you a ton. So thank you guys so much for watching. I seriously appreciate it. If you have any questions at all, I mean anything, drop it in the comments down below. I answer very quickly. Okay, guys, if you guys are interested in, you know, having an AI agency, growing it, learning more about all this amazing stuff like reputation management and infusing AI into it, check out the link down below. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to have a video that's going to pop up at the end of the screen that's just going to be the ultimate reputation management tutorial. I recommend you check that out. It'll go in depth on this stuff. I also have a couple more really big reputation management videos coming out that are going to cover everything. I'm telling you, there is not a single video on YouTube that's going to be like these videos coming out. They are next level. So stay tuned for those. I think you're really going to like them. But other than that, guys, drop a comment down below if you have any questions. Check out the link if you're interested. And make sure you watch the video that pops up at the end of this screen.